Have you ever heard of a paradox? It's something that seems contradictory, but when you think about it carefully, is actually okay and not contradictory. Well, if you've been paying close attention to our class, we have a paradox on our hands. We've told you that the acceleration on Earth is always 9.8 meters per second squared downward. And that doesn't depend on what's falling, an apple, a bowling ball, a person, same speed, though I wouldn't want to be the person. Anyway, I digress. The point is that we've said acceleration is the same for every sort of object. But in our last lesson, we learned that the force of gravity depends on mass. So wouldn't that mean the force of gravity is different for those objects? Which one is it? It's a paradox. But it's easy to untangle, and we'll take a close look at that in this video. Like most things in life, when things seem contradictory, we can often untangle them by thinking very carefully about what we mean by the words that we're using. So let's take a look and figure out this paradox. Let's begin by reviewing our lesson objectives. First, we'll review gravitational force and acceleration, and we'll basically here be reviewing the paradox that it looks like gravitational force depends on mass while acceleration doesn't. How do we fit these together? Then we'll calculate gravitational acceleration on the Earth and actually show it doesn't depend on mass. We'll calculate gravitational acceleration on the Moon and show the same thing. And at the end, we'll quickly resolve our paradox. So first up, doesn't gravitational acceleration not depend on mass? In the late 1500s, the Italian scientist Galileo is said to have completed an important experiment with gravity. We are told that he dropped two different objects of different masses from this famous Leaning Tower of Pisa. To everyone's surprise, they fell at the exact same rate, despite the fact that they had different mass. And yet, we know that the gravitational force does depend on mass. Here in the blue, we see the masses. What's going on? Well, let's solve this paradox. This problem says, what is the gravitational acceleration for an object with an unknown mass on the surface of Earth? So we don't even know its mass, and yet we're going to find its acceleration, proving that the mass doesn't matter. The mass of the Earth is 6.0 times 10 to the 24th kilograms, and the radius of the Earth is 6.4 times 10 to the 6th. And then we're told that Newton's law is F equals ma, and we're given big G. Well, we're going to start here by writing down the force of gravitational attraction as big G, M1, M2, all over R squared. And now we're going to recall, as our problem suggests, that force is equal to mass times acceleration. And remember, our problem is looking for that A there, that acceleration. So we're going to substitute that in way over here. But before we do that, let's decide what mass that is. Is that mass 1 or mass 2? Well, we'll just call it mass 1. That's the mass of the thing being attracted to Earth. And that means mass 2 is the mass of the Earth. So let's get rid of the 2. And we'll put a little E there just to remind us that that's the mass of the Earth. Now we'll substitute in our M1A, and we'll get M1 times A equals G M1 ME all over R squared. And here's where all the magic happens, my friends. When we want to solve for acceleration, we divide both sides by mass 1. What does that do? That doesn't make mass 1 cancel out just on the left. Mass 1 cancels out here and here. So notice, because force depends on mass and the gravitational strength depends on mass, they cancel out. So what we get is A equals G M E over R squared. Check it out. There's no mass 1 anywhere. It's fallen away. And so what that means is we can just solve for acceleration by plugging in the variables we have here, which is big G, 6.67 times 10 to the minus 11th, times the mass of the Earth, which is 6.0 times 10 to the 24th, all over the Earth's diameter, I'm sorry, radius, which is 6.4 times 10 to the 6th, and we're going to square that. Now, here's the magic. When we plug that into our calculator correctly, what do we get? When we round to two sig figs, we get 9.8 meters per second squared. That's the acceleration due to gravity on the surface of the Earth, regardless of mass. So what we figured out here is that it is true that the strength of the gravitational force depends on mass. But because our acceleration depends on mass as well, they cancel out. Let's try that one more time. This trick turns out to work whether you're on the moon or on Earth. No matter where you are, the acceleration due to gravity is independent of mass. Let's take a look. What is the gravitational acceleration for an object with an unknown mass on the surface of the moon? The mass of the moon is 7.4 times 10 to the 22nd kilograms, and the radius of the moon is 1.74 times 10 to the 6th. Recall that Newton's second law tells us that F equals ma, and we get big G. Go ahead, try this problem on your own. Can you solve for the gravitational acceleration on the moon? All right, well, hopefully you made some progress there. If you didn't finish, that's okay. Let's take a look. We start the same way we did before, with F equals G M1 M, and instead of putting 2, I'm just going to go ahead and put little m. That's the mass of the moon. All divided by R squared. Now we know that force is equal to ma, and specifically we're going to use mass 1 times a, where 1 is just our object with an unknown mass. And so then we get m1 times a equals g m1 m of the moon over r squared. And once again, we'll divide both sides by mass 1. And once again, mass 1 falls out of the equation entirely, and we get acceleration equals g, this times the mass of the moon, divided by r squared. And so now we can solve for the acceleration by plugging in g, which we know is 6.67 times 10 to the minus 11, times the mass of the moon, which is 7.4 times 10 to the 22nd, all divided by the distance squared, which is 1.74 times 10 to the 6th squared. When we plug that into our calculator and round to two sig figs, we get 1.7 meters per second squared. That's always the units for acceleration there. And that's the acceleration you would experience on the moon. Once again, doesn't depend on mass. So here you have it. Gravitational force depends on mass, but that's not the same as gravitational acceleration. Gravitational acceleration does not depend on mass. So acceleration and force are just two different things. And once we've separated them, we realize how both can be true. What we've learned in this video is we've reviewed gravitational force and acceleration, and then we calculated gravitational acceleration on the Earth, and lastly, we calculated gravitational acceleration on the Moon. Hey, hey.